Has the debate over the Gujarat riots, the Zakia Jafri case, all the others about the way the SIT report has gone, has it all become more and more a debate of perception? Has it become a perceptional battle between both sides? If not, then why were one set of activists, Teesta Setalwad and others, claiming victory today when the court said that the SIT report should be given in full along with all supporting documents by March 15th to Zakia Jafri? By claiming victory at every stage of the development, has this become some kind of a perceptional battle? Also importantly tonight, as we head into the main and last debate on the News Hour this evening, on the debate, we have Mukul Sinha with us, who is a very important petitioner and lawyer in this case. And he joins us. Thank you, Mukul Sinha. And we also have with us Yatin Oza, who represents the point of view of the Gujarat government. Today, the SIT lawyers Mukul Sinha said to you, I have two questions for you tonight. First of all, has this become a perception issue? You know, you need to always make it look as if you are on the winning side. Secondly, the SIT lawyers today said that you and Teesta Setalwad have no locus standi in the Zakia Jafri case, and the court dismissed your petition seeking the SIT closure report. How do you view that?
I think let's get the facts straight, Arnob. I think you have got the whole order wrong. The court has not stated that we do not have locus standi. Firstly, so far
the
as
SIT has, Mukul the SIT has,
concerned, he
SIT
did not.
SIT lawyers said.
What the SIT lawyer says is quite irrelevant after the order has come. The order has said certain things. The application is not filed by me. The application is filed on behalf of a witness, Amrish Patel, who is a witness in the Naroda Patia case, by his lawyer. So let's get that first fact straight. Now, the court has held that as the SIT has asked for 1 month's time to produce all other documents, and as long as the other documents are not before the court will not be in a position to decide as to whether Amrish Patel is an affected party or not. Therefore, at this stage, his application was not granted. These are a word. Huh? At this stage, his application is not granted. The court is going to wait for the SIT to file the rest of the document. I believe a similar order has been passed in Zakia Jafri's case also, and also
so,
in Teesta Setalwad's case.
Question is,
so therefore, there is no order rejecting.
No, I take
Amrish Patel's application, nor is something against
Mukul Sinha. Mr. Mukul Sinha, why are we discussing this?
Yeah,
we are discussing this tonight in the context of the fact that yourself and Teesta Setalwad have extremely high profile petitioners and activists in this particular case, and hence the Gujarat government does perceive you not to be their best friends. They would be extremely happy simply by the fact tonight. 1 minute, sir, that even though the court did not directly say in as many words that you and Teesta Setalwad have no locus standi in the matter, the dismissal of your petition, sir, seeking the SIT report, spells out the court's decision on your locus standi. There are people in the Gujarat government who want you out. They say, let this be settled. Who want Mukul Sinha out, Teesta Setalwad out. They say, let's deal with the petitioner directly. And tonight, those people are saying their point is proven. Your response before I go to Yatin Oza tonight. Yes, sir. Your response to that, sir.
You're asking me?
Yes, sir. That's to you.
Mukul Sinha's response.
Mukul Sinha's response.
Okay, I'll tell you one thing. The Gujarat government would very definitely be happy if the lawyers who are representing the victims are out of picture.
Yes.
Because they have carried out one of the worst massacres. They have conspired in 2002, and it is just like the Sikh riots that you were just discussing a few minutes back. None of the persons who were in the position of responsibility wants to be tried. So therefore, they would obviously be happy.
Oh.
But let me tell you once again, let me repeat that this order that has come today does not question our locus standi. It only says that at this stage, the application is not granted.
But we are on
That's the issue
of locus standi. Not because the court said it, because the SIT said it.
Now let me tell you. Now let's come to that.
Side.
We have locus standi.
That's the question.
Now, let me now tell you about the locus standi.
Now, let me get Yatin Oza in first. My question to Yatin Oza is, how can the SIT say that the gentleman you're debating with tonight has no locus standi? He and Teesta Setalbad have been fighting for justice ever since Modi is battling to prove himself non-culpable. Isn't it baseless to say that Mukul Sinha has no locus standi?
Let us absolutely baseless and worthless.
What?
We are governed by Code of Criminal Procedure. Criminal Procedure Code envisages copy of the fine. This is not a case. There are thousands and millions of cases pending in the court where closure reports have been filed by the investigating authority. The scheme of the Criminal Procedure Code is that either the complainant or the victim will have a right to get the copy of that report. Magistrate shall issue a notice to the complainant and or receipt of that notice along with all the papers of investigation. Complainant will have a right to file a protest petition, and after the protest petition is filed, at that stage, mind you, an accused has no right to be heard. Who is going to be affected? Then the magistrate decides.
No, you tell me how Mukul Sinha.
Every other agency.
Why are you digressing?
Therefore, every other agency other than.
One second.
I am not digressing.
Tell Mr. Mukul Sinha how he has no locus standi in the case. This gentleman has been representing a number of Gujarat tribes. Tell him how he has no locus standi. You back the SIT on this, so tell him how he has no locus standi.
Yes, I am telling you. And first of all, I explained the scheme of the Criminal Procedure Code. Unless he is a complainant.
See that position.
1 minute, Mukul. Did I disturb you when you were putting your viewpoint? Unless Mukul Sinha is a complainant or in any manner victim, these are the only two categories who are entitled to a report. If Mukul Sinha can be given a report, if Teesta Setalbad can be given a report,
where do you get this law, Mr. Rosa?
There may be
somebody
sitting in Kerala, somebody sitting in Jammu and Kashmir,
why not
sitting in Maharashtra can say that I also sympathize. Please give me the copy.
Yeah, so why not? Now he's
again you are disturbing.
No, one second. He's not disturbing. I am interrupting.
Let me respond because you see, it is every report, final report, is a public document, and any person who wants a certified copy can apply, and we have made an application for the certified copy of that report.
Which has been
and
rejected.
Under the criminal manual, which this has is been a rejected. Permissible application.
Which has that been rejected?
And
which petition has been rejected?
No petition has been rejected.
Your petition seeking the SIT report has been rejected.
You listen, Arnab, just listen carefully and let Yatin also listen carefully. That the order of the court is only that the SIT is still to produce the documents for which it has asked for time, 1 month's time. The time is given, and till the documents are furnished, the court is not in a position to decide whether we are an affected party. Let's use the word affected party. And if we are an affected party, the order is kept in abeyance.
No, what's it? Why are you so keen?
So therefore, there is no question of locus standi.
No.
These are all
made up,
going on since afternoon.
Why are you so keen?
Could have deferred it.
Why are you so keen that Mukul Sinha and Teesta Setalbad back off? 1 minute. If you're not threatened, if you're not insecure, if you have nothing to hide, then why do you want to make a symbolic victory of?
We are not at all afraid, or we don't want them to back out, but we are talking in terms of law where they have no locus standi. Court, as my friend says, that then court could have deferred the hearing, saying that I'll peruse the papers and then I'll decide. Today the order is of rejection. Let us be very clear about it. If the viewpoint which
Mr. Oza read the order, he's also flying the kite here.
I have, Mukul. It is rejection.
You haven't, because if you have had, then this is the. I'm telling you the exact word. The exact words are that till the SIT furnishes the document, it would not be possible for the court to decide who is the affected party.
Sir.
And this it has said even for Zakia Jafri.
No, sir.
So if you have not read it,
sir,
please
no.
do not
sir, 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 1 minute. Let me tell. No, 1 minute. Let me tell you what it says.
Definitely.
The SIT. 1 minute. The judge added. Did he or did it? Mukul Sinha. The SIT report won't be given to Teesta Setalwad and Mukul Sinha since they are not the aggrieved in the case. I think that is what the judge said.
Exactly.
Right?
No, it has not said it will not give. It has said it will wait for the SIT to furnish the rest of the documents and then it will decide whether we are an affected party.
Do you think,
not.
Mukul Sinha, let me ask, do you think there are a lot of people like Yatinoza, others in the Gujarat government who want to see you and Teesta Setalwad back off now? They want to see you back
oh,
off.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh,
no,
yes. Because ultimately, this is the first time perhaps in the history of India that there is a very consistent and persistent struggle to get the people to justice, which did not happen in the Sikh riots. Why did the main leaders in the Sikh riots go scot-free? Because nobody really took up the cudgel for years together.
Yes,
this is the first time for last 10 years we have tried to bring all the culprits, and that's what they are very angry about.
Let me tell you, we are not at all angry, nor Mukul, we are afraid of either you or Teesta. You can come with 10 times the more force with which you have come till now. But we are very clear in making our allegations that you don't have a heart to reach to victims in real sense. You don't want to help them. You have a hidden agenda with a pointed finger only against one man at the instance of our political opponents to see who have hopelessly failed in past to match with the stature of that man and to bring him down by hook or crook. You people under the guise and grab of helping the victims have pointed the fingers only against Mr. Modi, and your only aim is to see by hook or crook Mr. Modi is brought in. And to get that
Mr. Oza,
objective achieved,
can I remind you of one thing?
An opportunity. This is what we feel, and this is what
Mr. Sinha, get
your
in.
Viewpoint since last 10 years.
Last word to Mr. Sinha. You've gone straight out tonight at Mr. Sinha. So now he has a right to respond. I was closing the debate, but since you have gone on a hard-hitting personal attack on Mr. Sinha, he has a right to respond before I wrap up. Go ahead, sir. He said he wanted to remind you of something. Go on.
But then 1 minute, give me
a... No, one minute. He has to
attack. Or no, I'll take care of myself.
Give me one minute.
Mr. Yatinoza, just remember your own conduct in 2000 December.
Then have his response.
Yatin, why don't you just listen now? In 2000 December, you stood from Maninagar against Mr. Modi himself, accusing him of being a mass murderer.
2002.
And this is the conduct which you are now showing. Who will ever believe in a guy like you?
Not one speech.
Okay.
You had stood as a Congress candidate against Modi in 2002.
Mr. Modi as a mass massacre.
And you had resigned from BJP to do that.
Not a word that what you said.
Turncoats like you can hardly make a moral, give moral lectures.
And if you are Dr. Sinha, now even minorities have understood you. You contested from the A constituency.
Minorities have understood me, but the majorities have understood you.
And you could not get votes in four figures. The votes
majority
that you got
has understood you very well.
In the assembly segment.
Why do you come and give moral and ethical lectures when you yourself have turned yourself around?
Okay. Now, gentlemen, the issue is tonight, and it's open to the news hour viewers. Do they think the SIT is being unfair by saying Teesta Setalwad and Mukul Sinha have no locus standi in the case? Do you agree with Mr. Yatinoza tonight?
That was the main debate. The delay is really going to defeat the purpose of justice.
Sure. Do you agree with Yatinoza or Mukul Sinha? Tell us what you think. I'll take your feedback, and I promise these two gentlemen by tomorrow I'll send your feedback to them. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on debate number 3 on the news hour tonight.